Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and a very good evening, as it's a happy evening to watching this video. So friends, in this video we are gonna see some of those important updates regarding Tata Power, and I think we have come a long range in Tata Power Company Limited. And usually I focus this power companies, power generating companies, media sector companies and other IT companies, etc. So Tata Power Company Limited or Co Limited, we are going to see three key important updates, and after that I'm going to share regarding the price view and how much further it can go, right? And this is what we're going to see in this video. So let us jump directly into this. And the first thing what you're going to see is that CCI players, I mean Competition Committee of India, claims that Tata Power purchase of NESCO utility. So with this purchase, right, with this purchase, Tata Power now can serve the entire population of Odisha, which is nearly 9 million consumers, right? I think this is a great achievement by Tata Power Company Limited. It's doing at this kind of level, and this is the first point that we should know. So by acquiring this 51% management control and state-owned grid corporation of Odisha will remain hold 49%. So with this deal, Tata Power now can serve the entire population of Odisha, which is nearly 9 million customers, right? And moving on to the next factors regarding the shareholding pattern value of Tata Power. So Tata Power is nearly holding around 4 stocks value for around 400 crores. I think that is one of another information that you should know, because they are so-called promoters, or they are the so-called main person in Nelco Limited. So Tata Power is holding around 48%, and I also discussed about it many times with you, right? And moving on, this thing is that Tata Power rolls out peer-to-peer solar energy trading project, and this is a new initiative taken by Tata Power to trade the solar energy things. But Bob, even after saying these things, right, we must note here one thing. Tata Power is basically a power generator, power distributor come renewable energy producer. Tata Power generally being so-called non-renewable energy producer as well as a renewable producer, they have solar power with them, right? Now what I basically thought is that these renewable sectors are getting, or I mean the renewable energy sectors, renewable car sectors, bike sectors are getting so much of excess valuation in the market. So what I basically thought is that if Tata Power Limited could demerge there, or not even demerge, could spun off, or could in any way showcase their so-called Tata Power Solar or Tata Solar in a different way, it could even add value to the shareholders of Tata Power Company Limited. Because basically being a company which was trading in the range of around 70 to 1, but if you see the share price, right, it has not hardly crossed 140 or 150 very many if you take days back. But being in March lows of around 27 rupees previous year, to almost I think it has crossed around 114 rupees. So which means basically a share has jumped around 5 times. I think that is a really a very good value contribution that we should be having, or we are having here. Now speaking about it, now you could have the thought process how much further more Tata Power can rise. Now how much further more Tata Power can rise belongs upon or be upon two factors, right? And the first thing is that regarding this COVID problem, etc, etc thing, and a market mania momentum, and that is the first point we should know. And the second point we should know is that how much Tata Power management could even add a valuation to their company, right? Because I think the main problem of this company is that debt. Since the debt has been, many Tata groups are suffering from debt, but since the almost within this year, many companies the debt problems has been resolved, the new way has been born for Tata companies. I mean not only for Tata Power, you can take it for Tata Motors, and you can take it for many of the Tata listed companies. So basically I think this thought process is going to be continued, and if they can do anything positively for Tata Solar Limited, I think that is going to be a value additional point for Tata Power Company Limited. So let us see how it's going to grow, and this is about Tata Power Company. So what is the real valuation expecting Tata Power Company Limited? Sir, I believe, I don't seriously expect a strong big surprise move. Let us see whether if it can cross 140 rupees. I think 140 rupees is a very much of years so-called resistance mark, because since the company is already having a 33,000 crores of market capital right now, it is already hugely valued company. I think it could be further even more value extended if they can change their way of so-called renewable business, which could even add further value to the Tata Power Company Limited. Thank you friends, and bye. And if you want to get many more updates, then make sure you do join my Telegram channel. Especially click the subscribe button so that you could get many more updates regarding many more shares.